We're finally here. The Okinawa Training Camp. This sunny southern island is beckoning with its palm-lined beaches.
First thing in the morning and he's already yelling. Oh, why do airplanes have to take off so early in the morning all the time?
I get the feeling you're not a morning person, are you, Ibarada?
Not at all. And since we've got this weird outsider with us, it's even more unpleasant than usual.
That's not very friendly, Ina. We haven't seen each other for a long time.
Professor Ikeda, why is this manga artist here with us anyway?
Well, I just thought having Yamamoto along for the ride would be fun for everyone.
Don't you think that's a lot of luggage just for the two of them?
I see we're all here. Let's go. Ready? Let's begin that experiment known as a training camp.
Show me love, show me love, touch it, cuts no, I might can't get you listen, I gotta call that evo, motome yo, snug, tete, tete, no, bala, don't quit. Nana, yak, man.
Beginning of a trip always makes my heart race a little. Makes it beat just a little harder.
Press up against me.
Huh? Wait.
Let me have your saliva now.
Now's not really a good time.
Sorry to interrupt, sir, but could you please fasten your seatbelts? We're about to take off.
When our experiment's been completed...
We're very sorry. They're pretty much done.
Yes, we're finishing now. We're sorry about that.
Yukimura, please! You can't conduct your experiments in public places like this.
And why not?
It may be necessary to measure oxytocin, but even I wonder about its appropriateness right now.
What's so inappropriate? If Himuro and I initiate close contact, it isn't like it would cause problems for anyone else.
It's not like that. It would cause big problems for me if people assume I'm involved.
What benefits come from following the inane dictates of society?
You should be aware that your concept of tact is infinitely approaching zero, Yukimura. Now, you may not understand this, but it's inappropriate to conduct tests like these in a public venue. Physical contact experiments in public are forbidden. Is that clear?
I suppose.
What do I do now? For some reason, I feel like cuddling close to Yukimura. Now that physical contact is forbidden, I find myself yearning for that sensation of pressing close to him. No. I was the one who said we couldn't. Somehow I have to restrain myself until we're somewhere out of public view.
You know, it's amazing how things this big can fly, isn't it? How does an airplane stay up in the air anyways? It's something about wind over the wings creating lift, right? At least I think that's it.
There are quite a few theories involving lift, actually. But what's most important is... the air flowing over the top of the wings and the air flowing under the wings move at different speeds. According to the Bernoulli principle, this explains the differential in air pressure which pulls the wings upward. I want to hug Yukimura! During flight, the wings create air currents which circulate in the vicinity of the airplane. All of this has been explained in the Kutta-Joukowsky theorem. I want to press my forehead to Yukimura's and rub up against him! According to Kutta and Joukowsky, The air flowing over the top of the wings travels faster than the air currents below the wings for that reason. And according to Bernoulli's principle, the faster the air current, the lower the pressure, and the slower the current, the greater the pressure. That difference of pressure is exactly what's at work, providing the force to lift the wings. And after that, they become one.
That conclusion is absurd. You should know they don't become one.
How could you say something so awful? You're horrible, Yukimura!
Huh? Why?
Bernoulli's principle. First, take a tissue and stick it to your forehead. Then, look straight down. For some reason I don't quite understand, if you exhale gently, the tissue gets sucked towards your breath. Evidently, the science behind this phenomenon is what allows airplanes to fly. It's super exhausting, but you stupid humans ought to give it a try, Bear. 'Cause I'm out of oxygen.
Oh my god! I can't believe it. It's really a tropical paradise.
Got a day. Were you wondering why the palm trees are there? This master of Okinawa will now explain. Because it's Okinawa's sweetheart. That's why!
I love it!
It's because palm trees grow in subtropical climates, right?
Oh, wow! The ocean in Okinawa is so amazingly blue! It's stunning!
This sure isn't a view we'd see in the Kanto area.
I believe the intense blue of the ocean around Okinawa is due to things like coral and shells turning into chalky white sand, right, Professor?
Because when pale hues combine with blue, they create an entire palette of very pretty colors.
Wow.
I hear that the Kuroshiro Current, which flows near Okinawa, is extremely low in plankton, which is another factor in its being very clear.
I'm totally blown away! This is my first time ever staying in a gorgeous hotel like this!
How the heck did you manage it? And on that pitiful training camp budget.
Funny you should bring that up. It was Yamamoto. She's the one who paid the difference in hotel fees.
Huh?
Yep. You know, I just wanted everyone to be able to stay somewhere nice.
Man, that's awesome! Are you some kind of goddess?
How can we ever thank you?
That must have been quite a lot of money.
Oh, don't worry about that. I lost hope in my financial future years ago. I live on bean sprouts and flour now.
Don't spend what you don't have!
If my meager savings have to vanish to secure a lovely place for us to stay, to allow us a good time every evening and interesting experiences, then I consider it an investment.
It so happens that I know this person very well. So listen to me when I say be careful around her.
Huh?
She will do whatever it takes to make sure her career as a manga artist finally succeeds.
You make me sound horrible. Don't be silly, Aina.
The blue sea of a southern isle, the sound of waves crashing, and there she is, Aika. In your bikini, you outshine all the other women in the world.
Well, I have to admit, playing on the beach with dolls is new.
Let me remind you that Aika is anything but a doll. Even for you, Yukimura, there are things that you can and cannot
say. Sorry to keep everybody waiting.
Oh.
I bought us something nice and cold to drink.
Thanks a lot.
Sorry, everybody. It took us such a long time. Yukimura, what are you waiting for? Come on, hurry up.
Oh, Kanade, relax, would you?
That suits you pretty well, Yukimura.
Gag at your tongue, Yukimura.
What's wrong? Do I look strange, Yukimura?
No, I wouldn't say that. I can't look directly at her. So that's what they call a bikini? How can I put it? Himuro, she looks 2.34 times more beautiful than ever.
Everything's okay, isn't it? Does the swimsuit make me look weird? I haven't worn a swimsuit since elementary school. What's he thinking? I wish he'd just say something.
Absorbing this much UV is gonna make me melt.
So you're just as much an indoor type as ever, huh?
Okay, we'll make the Ikeda lab encampment right about here. There we go.
All you men look pretty hot yourselves, you know that?
It's true. Seeing Yukimura in a bathing suit is something totally different. Under this sun, his pale skin shines and sparkles. It's amazing. It's exactly as though he...
Yukimura, you are way too pale. You're like a reflector board.
You're as pale as I am, so what's the difference?
Well, yeah, maybe. But guys are more of a flat plane in front, so it's kind of like...
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's only because you hole up and do research all the time, that's all.
From a distance, he looks even shinier, doesn't he?
He really does.
Cut that out!
Oh yeah, women in bikinis. Wonder who's gonna take one of those beauties home, what do you say?
Yuichi, you're really amazing. It's like you're public enemy number one for any woman.
Huh? Listen, Shikicho, you're not in any position to talk about anyone. You should try talking to girls once in a while too, you know? How about it? Those two look kinda interesting. Good morning, ladies.
Good morning?
Nothing, my mistake!
There are some strange guys around.
Odd thing about him. I feel like I've met him somewhere before, you know?
Ah, Himuro, Kanade! There you are! We're about to start the melon splitting
game!
That's
great!
Yay! Okay, it's all set! Ready whenever you are!
Alright! Let's have those directions!
Given that you're standing on the starting point and you're facing the imaginary axis, the watermelon is placed exactly at 2 plus 3i.
And that means what?
Kosuke, she's just talking about a complex plane. Forward 3i, right 2. That's how you have to move.
Forward 3i? What does that even mean?
You don't remember? Complex numbers, really? As a science geek, I'd be awfully embarrassed if I were you.
Wait a minute. If you ask me, there's a much bigger problem with the directions here. I mean, do I go right 2 steps or 2 meters? Give me a unit at least. Here, right?
Not good enough, Tarasuke. That info's enough for a real science geek to split the watermelon.
Is it here? I mean, come on! Where the hell is it?
Okay, and with that, it's your turn next, Professor Ikeda.
This is the first time I've ever played the melon-splitting game. I wonder if I can do it right.
Okay, the watermelon is at 3 plus 7i.
Hey, what do you know? I did it! It's just where you said it was, Ibarada. I'll bet that you're a little surprised, Kosuke. Although it's true that 3 plus 7i doesn't tell you the precise distance to the watermelon, you'll see a complex plane isn't any different than a regular graph. From the ratio 3 to 7, we learn that the watermelon sits along an angle of about 67 degrees, which means if I follow the angle in a straight line, I'd find the watermelon without a hitch. Once I've explained it, it's a piece of cake.
That's not what we're surprised about. Excuse me, but do we know where Himuro and Yukimura have run off to?
I'm pretty sure they've gone off to those rocks down there. Things are probably getting started now.
Okay, I don't think anyone can see us.
I'm ready for the experiment now. Finally, I can cuddle close to him. I'm happy about it, but when I think about it rationally, such close contact in these outfits, isn't it a little crazy?
Hold on a second. I'm really going to have close contact with Himuro? She's in a bathing suit! This degree of exposure? The direct skin-to-skin contact area isn't comparable to everyday amounts! On top of which, in order to produce the hormone, it's best for the contact to be as close and tight as possible! As tight as possible?
I think I'm going to hydrate a little bit first. I collected so much saliva, my mouth's dry.
And I forgot to adjust the calculations!
Oh, come on. I feel so embarrassed about wanting him. What am I supposed to do about it?
How can I have close contact with her? I mean, she's 2.34 times more beautiful than usual!
I think the stimulus might be a little too strong for Yukimura.
That's where you're supposed to just go and grab her, okay?
The two of them embracing in the water. It'd be so exciting to see!
What are you all doing here? For crying out loud.
Don't worry there, Yukimura. Everyone feels a little lost their first time. It's just how it is. Don't worry about it.
Whatever you're blathering about, just stop it.
Those lovely swimsuits are going to waste. I fully support the two of you in your experimentation. Let's think about what kind of contact would be best.
When two people look for close physical contact, they should consider positions that offer the greatest contact surface area. If we turn it into a mathematical problem, we can look for the ideal solution for it.
In the lab, we performed what is generally known as a regular hug. But there may be a position that creates a greater surface area for contact.
The human body has more surface area on the front and back than on the sides. If the front of the body and under the arms are held closely in a hug, some might say the position provides an exceedingly broad area of close contact. If that's true, then with this position, or even this one, the amount of close contact doesn't change much.
That one's pretty nice. I like that.
Wait a minute. If they entwined their legs around each other, wouldn't that help to increase the surface area?
If they did, it would turn out to be something like this.
Kind of reminds me of a cicada.
Would it be too hard for both of them to wrap their legs? What about that?
Yes, I'm afraid. Which means it would be difficult to increase the amount of close contact any more than this.
No, that's wrong. We're overlooking something. When the fronts of the bodies are in close contact, there's no reason to match the direction of up and down, which means this.
Oh, what kind of life form is that?
That is horrible in ways I can't imagine.
However, it greatly increases the number of variations.
No, it doesn't!
How acrobatic is this couple anyway?
I've just realized something shocking from a long time ago.
What? What is it?
I was remembering what happened when I hugged a girlfriend with bigger breasts. I felt this kind of distance between us. With big breasts, when you bring your bodies close, it creates a gap and the area of close contact diminishes.
So then you mean that hugging some flat-chested girl increases the amount of close contact?
Wrong again. According to this theory, the greatest amount of close physical contact would be when two men hold each other.
That's true!
This discovery is extremely significant. We need to put it into practice to verify it, don't you think?
It's true that the reasoning seems correct, but it's...
And we just happen to have two guys here with us. Come on, let's
go. Cut that out! You just want to see it, that's all!
That's it!
I don't want to do this!
Cut it out!
It feels like everyone's having a lot more fun than they were before.
What's he doing?
It's the ocean!
Tarasuke, it's dangerous! Tarasuke! Tarasuke!
Tarasuke, you'll have to be careful when you go to the beach. They have these things called riptides, okay?
Okay. Oh, do those hurt a lot, Anna?
No, I'm okay, don't worry.
Don't do that. When it hurts, you have to say so. If anyone does anything mean to you, I'll protect you, because I'm a man who lives on love.
Oh, thanks a lot, Tarasuke!
I love you so much, Anna!
After that, you went back and peed in the ocean, if I remember correctly. Ah, the memories.
I can't take this! My past isn't as dark as you say it is!
You were such a cute little kid when you were young, and then you had the terrible idea of growing up.
And you stayed a tiny pipsqueak while your eyes rotted away inside your head. You remember a person's disgrace in every detail.
That's because women remember everything. Coordination between the right and left brain is stronger in women than men. It's harder to forget experiences where emotions were involved. All those times I was in danger and you became a human barrier to protect me, I'll never be able to forget them.
Yeah, I might believe that if it came from someone a little more sensitive.
Oh, if you're headed to the bathroom, pick up some roasted squid on the way back.
It's that science geek from before. Why is she in Okinawa?
What happened, Yuichi? Both of those girls were really cute.
Let me guess now. Don't tell me you got dumped, Yuichi.
Of course not, you moron. When I saw her face, she just wasn't my type.
You're getting slow in your old age, dude. You know that? Hurry up and go grab a girl or two while this stuff's hot.
Don't worry, I'm already on it. Watch me hit on her.
Hey. A little small, but not bad at all.
Right? You could play all day long with that one. What do you guys say?
Jeez, I don't believe how much this roasted squid actually costs. Huh? That's Ibarada, but it's weird. Doesn't it look like they're ganging up on her? There's no way. What is that woman up to now? No, it's a trap. She's just making it look like they're doing that. Yukimura was talking about that before, wasn't he?
I know you've heard the story of Schrodinger's cat, haven't you? In quantum physics, the same object can be in two different states in the same moment.
Which means that right now, she's getting ganged up on for real, and she's just talking peacefully are the two states, and it's not clear which she's in. If I observe her, then it ought to become clear which it is. I'm willing to bet that she's actually just having fun talking about Pokemon Do or something, so you know there's gonna be a punchline. What the? What's going on, dude?
The hell are you doing?
Well, I'm not really doing this because I want to. But you see, pal, I'm a man who lives on love. So I'm sorry, but this little pipsqueak is off limits, you got that?
Tarasuke, it's not like they did anything to me. It's okay.
Yeah, we were just playing Pakido, dude, when you came blasting in.
You gotta be kidding me! Schrodinger's cat! I misunderstood! I'm so sorry!
Don't worry about it. We're sorry, too. Yuichi always grabs girls' arms like that.
That's right. I mean, we are talking about Yuichi here.
This little pipsqueak here, she's off limits. That is so cool. That's, like, super cool.
Shut up already!
Just like you said so long ago, you really did protect me.
Cut it out! Forget I said anything!
I could never forget that. Memories where emotions are involved can't be forgotten. How could I forget this? I'll never forget it as long as I live. Thanks, Tarasuke. Thank you for protecting me. Thanks. Oh, this is so ridiculous.
Everyone, shall we go back?
We had so much fun. I took so many reference photos, I can't wait to organize them. Did something go wrong?
Please don't mind me. I just had a little repeat of a super dreadful level of my dark past.
Himuro, I'm really sorry. I wanted to return right away, it's just...
If you weren't feeling well, it was nothing you could help.
Ha! I just can't tell her! He thought so hard about that stupid couple's greatest close contact problem that he got so excited he passed out.
I'm glad you all found a way to enjoy yourselves, everyone. I was able to do some weighted long-distance swimming I hadn't done in ages.
Why do you train your body so hard, pushing it beyond all limits?
There's this Nobel Prize winner in physics from Saitama University. His name's Professor Kuze, and I had a chance to meet him.
Yeah?
At the time, I wasn't able to lay a single finger on him. And I'll tell you, Professor Kuze's not the only one. In the world of academics, there are unimaginable monsters, seething in tremendous numbers, geniuses that defy the imagination. You won't have a chance to survive in the world dominated by superhumans if you don't train at least a little. The professors examining you at the presentations tomorrow are also pretty strong. Let's do our best, okay?
Huh? We're supposed to be giving our presentations at a huge gathering of monsters?
She said, quaking with fear.
Next time, proof 10. Science types fell in love, so they tried giving presentations.